Hey, this is Mike with the Gizzard Stone. Today we're at Wolf Creek Campground near Markleyville, California. And we've got three trucks over here, and the kids are playing on the rocks over there. And we're going to load up here in a minute and drive up to Ebbetts Pass to run the Deer Valley Jeep Trail. Should be pretty cool. Let me show you the trucks. Familiar with this one. This is a Storm Runner. This is my 99 Toyota. And then we got Brent's Jeep. This is a JK Sport. He's got a lift and 35s. And he's got a true track in the front and an open dip in the rear. And this is Sean's JK Rubicon. Yesterday I was changing the oil in this and I noticed a little bit of gunk on the stuff over here, and noticed that the CV axle had been, had the boot had come out and had come undone, and all the grease had fallen off of it, so I ended up having to replace that yesterday. So that's all brand new. Should be good to go.
Oh yeah, it doesn't do that.
Oh wow. He wants me to go on this?
So we weren't on this, but you were.
Yeah,
okay. At this point though, we were sitting out.
Yeah.
This part this took 3 hours.
I didn't know he was doing that!
Oh, and you do it too.
He doesn't want to scratch anything on that.
Oh,
why would he do that?
Did you look under it?
It's scratched.
Oh, oh my just
goodness.
Do you often go with him, but
no,
not
No, this is new. This is a midlife thing.
Oh, okay.
But he did grow up doing it with his dad, but not in my time.
Gotcha.
And this was like, what, the first 100 feet of this trail? It was ridiculous.
And well, so at this point,
where
we thought,
are you?
We walked ahead of the kids. So that's what I'm wondering, do I have to be in the car if I come along? Well, not if you're going that slow. It's boring. If you're not the driver, yeah, I don't want to do that. I did some spotting and I did some driving, but not on the hard stuff. Well, there you are. That's you.
And then yeah, I mean, so in the very beginning, we were all under the impression
that driver.
This was the quote-unquote hard.
Oh yeah, don't bring him too far.
And after this little section, it was going to be.
I never thought it would be that hard.
Yeah, it took each jeep 1 hour. It took us 3 hours just for this little section.
Because of backing up and restarting?
Oh no,
going
this sort of doing this.
And they're moving rocks.
Perfect.
You know, to provide support or to get them out.
There's no other outfit cars like that aren't part of our
Yeah, that was a crazy part. That they actually,
they actually
closed the trail and the ranger just let us in. Like, he's like, oh, where are we supposed to be on this? We closed it. Came to do this.
Well,
I was like, oh, you guys do it.
Okay, well, that's nice, because what if you've met people coming down?
Coming down?
But how do we?
Is that a dog? I think it was a ranger.
The dogs were out, the kids were out. I mean, they were actually having fun.
They lots of snacks, though.
Snacks. If you endure M&Ms,
put food in the kids' face.
But we did run out of water.
It was a necessity of life.
Yeah, and they ran out of water. And so I was like, Brent, do you have any extra water? I got beer.
Only when they're showing signs of dehydration do we bust out
the beer. Well, we had some water, but not enough for like
an hour. Was
that water?
No, there's Chris.
Oh, he's good.
So no damage? Nobody had any, like,
shocking, right?
Yeah.
I really didn't think our Jeeps were quite ready for that.
I don't know, I might have brain damage.
I was emotionally scarred. I've actually been on
It was fun. This is
But I will say, the amazing thing about this trip is that nobody did wreck their car.
Right.
Nobody got a flat tire, which would have sucked to try to fix a flat.
I always wonder about that on my own.
Yeah. And the kids never blew up. Like, they were good.
They were super good.
I was amazed. Even on the way back to, because it took us an hour and a half
just to get here.
Was it hot that
on
day?
On the road.
Oh, yeah. High elevation.
It was not too bad.
No, it was hot.
It was hot.
So your two kids.
Our two kids. I don't, my daughter's not here tonight. We have a 7-year-old.
Oh, okay.
I smell like the horn.
It doesn't do it on purpose, though. It's hilarious.
His car is geared funny.
Oh,
so that
so his is different, then.
The first gear is actually pretty high on his car, so he can't just crawl up stuff. Ooh, he needs to gun it. And he has all the windows open. And there's some footage in here, and I took some pictures where the death, I mean...
So he doesn't have a low gear?
Oh, he just ran into that wall.
Right?
It's, well, I think
this is crawling.
Talking out my ass, but part of it has to do with the tires that he put on. He wants to get it re-geared.
We've done that.
We
know what that means.
There wasn't a box in the recycle bin for that one. No, there was just a receipt.
Oh, God.
Yeah, he tells me it's probably $1,500 to do that, which probably means it's
right.
Because if you're like the Rubicon,
might as well do this at the same time.
Because you're in there.
Yeah. And then they go into that place, and there's always some guy who Brent comes home and is like, I swear that guy just spent $30,000. He just went crazy and went $30,000.
In the meantime,
he's like, someone else is doing more.
Yeah. In the meantime, Brent's just spreading it out.
That guy just got it done in one day.
He doesn't have a boat. He doesn't have a Harley.
Well,
he does have some bikes.
Like bicycles?
Bicycles. Okay.
And I guess Brent is obsessed with doing Rubicon. This is his thing.
He did it with his dad, and he's trying to like have relive the Land Cruiser years. Is that a hard trail?
Oh, man, watch this part.
Rachel, watch!
Oh, I can't believe he's okay with that!
No, we almost broke the Jeep on this one.
Yeah,
this one was bad.
He mentioned none of this.
Not any of
this. She won't let him go out.
It was no big deal. Now you won't. Watch. Oh, is he going to tip over?
Well, you wouldn't notice if he had.
Apparently not, except that you should see how clean it is today. It looks like it just came off the lot.
Okay, wait, who's directing?
That's Sean. He's a good spot. And you know what cracks me up too is sometimes you guys are taking footage and then like you drop the camera because you'd be running towards the car.
What are you gonna do? Catch it?
So
does anybody else
spotting, not directing?
I have no idea.
They called it spotting.
Okay.
Spotting.
Right, okay.
Yes.
They were really funny. They got all the
driver!
Passenger! Hold it.
No, they should use
when they're connecting, they say spotting, that's what they say.
Yeah.
Because that's that side, not left or right.
They should have sailing terms.
Oh, yeah.
Like, what are the sailing terms?
G and ha. Is that for
that's a horse?
That's for oxen.
Right, no, I think it's like jib side and
starboard.
Yes.
Lee. One wheel up in the air. Oh, you.
I'm such a sucker. So next weekend he's going to a party in Las Vegas. Is he going to tone it down as much as he tones this down?
Dude, what happened in Vegas? Sean and Brent fell down like 6 times that day, guys.
What? And they were freaking out, you know?
What's going
to get out of the way? They had a hard time with it. So this is that same one that we just saw Brent do.
Yeah. How long is this
video? We're about halfway through that.
Halfway-ish.
I don't know if I do.
Oh, you 9 hours. We're only watching 20 minutes of our 9 hours.
So this next weekend, is that about this?
No!
Oh, okay.
You don't want a Jeep anymore!
So that car can't do it?
Yes, that's the story I'm sticking to.
Wait, you don't have a
ticket? Do you miss it? I miss parking it as opposed to a trick. I don't miss this.
Yes, all the fun. Brent gets a text. He's devastated.
Oh my god.
We knew we would.
Yeah, watch this. We knew we would. Look at this.
I told Ray, he's like, no.
No.
I'm like, Trump.
I think like he's got bad news about his dad or something.
No.
Like,
no.
I told Sean that's like a great gift to someone on a text.
You need to do it in text.
That's a man in person, or he should have conferred with him before.
Did this trick do him in?
No. It didn't tow our trailer.
Or the doctor.
And the doctor.
The dog.
I was amazed by that.
That one was good. You guys should have totally.
I mean, he could have wrecked his whole door, and I can just imagine
our extra car, which we don't have, the toy.
Oh, did you hear that?
We need
that's
to
really
yeah,
isn't that good?
Yeah, I think we have to do it again.
Oh,
that hurts.
Does that, and it still runs.
That's impressive.
Oh, there's a lot of,
what year is the
there's car? A lot of shit under there that's supposed to get hit, I guess.
What year is the car?
I'm going to say it's 97. It was the last year. Yeah, it is. But like I say, it's geared funny. So eventually, this is no longer on my wish list.
So tell me, when you guys went to Death Valley and you went over the Ebbetts Pass,
it was.
No.
How was it compared to you?
No, but I've been to.
This is the ladies' viewing. You have to wait your turn.
So Death Valley's like.
It is gross.
Like, no, yes, but there like, was one pass.
Yes. And so there was
that was
the Lippin' Pass, I think, was that road. So there's an area where
he doesn't move very fast.
And I was there filming at one point and they're all concerned that I was gonna get run over.
Well, no, it was only Mike that was ever a concern.
Because
Jeep goes
fast.
So slow,
yeah, yeah.
And Mike guns it, and like, you could be killed.
Yeah.
Oh, this one's good. I think
that
this
looks
sketch.
Yeah.
One of these, I haven't seen this version, but he gets
super
sad.
Yeah.
Oh, that was
not. No, he had to use
the.
Oh,
the log
is moving.
Stop!
Well, the log rolled into the Jeep, and then
yeah, look, the
gone.
Log's in a new location.
No, well, we have a lift.
You
can
lift.
We had to lift the log.
Wait,
why
she
did
could
you
have helped
with
the trailer
locker.
That's fair.
How many of you did
you
take to move the log?
We just rolled it up. Yeah.
So it was just.
But
was,
now you got it, Mike. Your decision to get rid of that is now problematic because now someone has to have a lift. Someone has to have.
I know, that's why he was mad at me. So the wind on the shoe.
Okay, wait, I did not hear why you said it's so high.
It's the dog.
Yes. So we have a trailer. And now we have a
dog.
You mean
like a camper trailer?
Yeah.
You can't get the door of the Jeep opens like this.
So
once the trailer's on and a bike rack or anything, you can't
open it at all. So there was nowhere to put the dog. So you had to put the dog in before you put anything else
and
on the
could die if you're not in a hurry because it's hot.
And really, again, this is a child problem
because
both our children
yes,
are still in like booster seats
yeah.
and kid seats. So you have to take the kid seats out, put the dog in, like it was just this.
We have a dog, but only one kid, so the one seat is always down.
Because that door opens
this way.
And
then and
with
so
the spare tire.
Yeah. So if you have bikes or
so
trailer.
Did you get something else? Mike's
pissed that you didn't get a forerunner. I want to be the next forerunner, but I'm not doing that.
Sean said there for the trailer that the forerunner would be a lateral move power wise because we were overheating the Jeep.
Lateral move!
Sean said a
it's
lateral move
that's
power
so,
wise.
That's like below the belt, man. That hurts to me. Oh, that's
right there.
Oh, does Mike disagree about the lateral?
I didn't hear this just now, but I'm sure it would make him tear up a little bit.
I don't know. We don't.
Oh my god.
would that pull our trailer?
Look
in the
at range? The sheer power of this vehicle.
Is it a V6?
Yes.
Yeah.
With weird hearing.
Yeah.
With weird hearing.
Inadequate hearing. But, you know, obviously with the right experienced driver, you know,
anything could
happen.
Oh,
right.
Oh. Okay, this is a really long video.
I know.
What is this for?
It's like for YouTube.
You used to get
there's
a hard on
over
four wheeling.
But
keep in mind, this is our life for 9 hours.
And eventually, we get
no.
To, so these guys used to ride mountain bikes.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, that seems like better for fitness.
Thank you. Yeah.
Yeah. I think that would be better for fitness.
So look, we made it to the top.
Well, we've reached the summit, I guess. The road looks like it goes down from here. The trail is really hard, really rough up to this point. It's surprising. The Forerunner made it the whole way. We had to do some rock stacking, but it didn't need any winching at all, which is cool. So here we are. There's this cool rock over here. We're going to go over there and see what the kids are looking at.
Yes, it looks like the kids like free range from them, gave them snacks. They had a great time.
Oh,
and they kept chasing lizards. They were so funny. Oh,
wow.
The lightning dragon. How come you didn't do any video today?
I don't know.
They were so dirty.
Filthy.
Oh my god.
So gross.
I was trying to get them. I think I got a picture of them, but they, you know, they wouldn't sit still. They're making faces. They're so fun.
I like that.
I called them.
Yeah.
So then we go to this and we're like, oh, wow, look at those no rocks. This is rad. That lasted, I swear, what, 50 feet?
Yeah, I drove.
It was
like, cool, now can I drive? And
then
I drove
this
and I was like,
again.
Get out!
Yeah.
I'm not going back.
Yeah.
I can't do it.
And we get
back.
Yeah,
I bet downhill is scarier than all.
Yeah, totally.
It got harder.
It was so lame.
Oh,
it was.
Spotty gloves? Are those spotty gloves?
Directing.
They have semaphore symbols.
Yeah, that's what. Like those batons, you know,
the
airport, or
flags,
like
those
nautical
flags.
Yes.
Oh, we got
the
winch!
Winch!
Which, we got our own jump. The Jeep is stuck, straddling a log. It's just stuck. Like, the pumpkin was, like, dragging on the fat thing, pink.
That's the
pumpkin
axe.
See, I told you.
It's called a pumpkin.
I'm
gonna call
this shit up. That.
Yeah. I know what you're talking about.
The lowest part.
The lowest part.
Well, I did hear
something
that
about new axles.
Oh, shit. Wait,
I think the guy with the 30 grand bill was buying new axles.
Are you sure his name wasn't Brandon?
Somebody
where was this? Yeah. Did Brent tell you the
acronym? I don't remember.
No.
Just empty every
time.
Now I know.
I mean, look at this.
So I end up walking
most of
it. Yeah. But this morning,
not many miles.
We could have hiked it
at that pace.
Yeah, we could have hiked it with the children.
There were hikers that actually passed us and then came back down.
And they're like, see, that's something my dad would say. So why? He would not get this. He's a sister, you know, looking from
70.
Why? Why do you do this? You can walk faster. It's costing gas. Potentially causing damage to a car.
Yeah. Why? I don't know that we use much gas, because it really wasn't worth it.
So we're still running for 6 hours.
When Mike and I went on a candle trip.
Oh, this is a lot.
Anyway, In the car during this. It's super uncomfortable.
It's the camel.
Oh, yeah.
Danielle filmed this.
I had a point. Yeah, I got
it was totally accosted by mosquitoes.
I had to get it because I'm like, oh, we finally got to the pretty freaking meadow. Look at this.
But there's mosquitoes at the meadow?
Well, it was, yeah, it was,
oh,
right,
no.
It was right at dusk. So they're
look
at
them. I see them. They're on the camera.
Yeah, they were like coming.
They ate wings.
I see them flying around.
They were terrible.
It was like, the African.
And there we go!
Do you remember that movie?
Oh, we talked about that.
Well, we did it. We got all the way through. Right now, it is 8 o'clock. We started at, like, 10:30. So, somebody got the message that this was a 3-hour trail. This is a 9-hour trail. The multiplier works. 3 hours, 3 vehicles, 9 hours total. But we made it. No damage. And the 4Runner did great. Awesome. So that was rad. I don't know that we'll do it again anytime soon. We're ready to get these guys down and feed them. Put them to bed.
Yeah, we gave them tons of chips when we finally made it.
Oh, yeah. Chips.
I had a bunch of chips with me, but we ran out of water, so I wouldn't give them any of the salty snacks.
Wait a minute.
Oh.
I was like,
oh, look, that's me!
Yeah.
Hey, the GoPro just fell off.